Okay, okay, let go.
Not till you apologize.
I can't breathe.
Fine.
What is your problem, man?
You are my problem. You're telling me lies.
What do you mean? I just said that Mexican Independence Day was coming up, and all of a sudden, you start choking me.
How? If we're in September, Cinco de Mayo is in May.
Cinco de Mayo and Mexican Independence Day are two different things.
What do you mean?
People always confuse those holidays, but today, I'm clearing things up.
What are you looking at?
Cinco de Mayo is on May 5th. It commemorates the day that the Mexican army successfully defended the city of Puebla against the French in 1862. The entire battle only lasted a day. Just like my last relationship.
Ramon, who are you talking to?
Chris, just come over here and sit down.
So when is Mexican Independence Day?
Mexican Independence Day is on September 16th. And it's exactly that. It's when Mexico got its independence from Spain back in 1810.
But how did they get their independence?
I'm glad you asked. Follow me. In September of 1810, a priest by the name of Miguel Hidalgo called for Mexico's liberation from Spain. The call to rise up against the Spanish is known as El Grito de Dolores, or Cry of Dolores. It's named after the town of Dolores, Mexico, where the speech took place. And it went something like this.
Enough is enough! Together, we can rise up against the Spanish. It's time to be free. Viva Mexico! Viva Mexico! Viva Mexico!
Wow, he really said that?
Well, no one really knows what he said, but his words inspired and the message spread throughout the land. The speech did spark an 11-year battle that resulted in Mexico's independence in 1821.
11 years? That's more than 10 years.
Yeah, it is, but it doesn't compare to the almost 3 centuries of Spanish colonial rule.
Wow, that's like more than 2 centuries.
Mm-hmm. And it wasn't until Spain signed the Treaty of Cordoba that Mexico finally got its independence.
So do you guys celebrate?
Yeah, we do. I'll show you how. Every year on September 15th, the night before Mexican independence, the Mexican president recreates El Grito on the balcony of the National Palace.
Ooh, that sounds fun.
It is. El Grito celebrates the heroes of the Mexican independence movement, and after each line, the audience replies with, Viva!
Viva!
Exactly like that. And at the end, the president also rings a bell as another tribute to Hidalgo.
Viva!
Okay, that's good. Anyway, you can also watch El Grito on TV, as most people do.
Mexicanos! ¡Viva los héroes que nos dieron patria!
¡Viva! Is that me?
Shh!
¡Viva Hidalgo!
¡Viva!
¡Viva Morelos!
¡Viva!
¡Viva la Independencia Nacional! ¡Viva México! ¡Viva México! ¡Viva México!
¡Viva México! Oh, that looks so fun. Do they have a party afterwards?
Oh, Mexican independence in Mexico is celebrated with parties, mariachis, parades, and food.
Food sounds so good right now. What type of food is usually eaten?
How about I show you? Follow me.
How many more times am I gonna follow you around? You're eating already?
Yeah, I was a little hungry.
So, are you gonna keep eating or are you gonna explain the food?
Oh yeah. Well, traditionally, on Mexican Independence Day, people like to eat menudo, which I was enjoying till you rudely interrupted me. It's also common to eat tamales and birria.
I love tamales and birria. Can I have a bite now?
Not yet. I have one more to show you. This is chiles en nogada.
Oh, wow. What is that?
These are stuffed poblano peppers topped with a walnut-based cream sauce, parsley, and pomegranate seeds.
It's beautiful.
What better way to celebrate Mexican independence than with a dish that represents the colors of the Mexican flag?
The Mexican flag has an eagle. Does that mean it has eagle meat inside it?
No, Chris, it does not have eagle meat.
Well, that's disappointing.
Anyway, now you know the difference between Cinco de Mayo and Mexican Independence Day, and I never want you to confuse the two again.
or what?
I promise I won't confuse the two.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Fine. You know what else you should know?
What?
That the Crazy Gorilla just launched their brand new street corn or elote plush on Vesco's.com for a limited time only.
Okay, I need to buy 5 of these.
Where at?
Vesco's.com.
Doesn't it look delicious?
It looks scrumptious.
Mm-hmm. And you should buy yours too right now at Vesco's.com. I mean, look at this thing. Whew. And if you guys like the video, make sure you like the video, subscribe for more videos, and follow.
Have Casanova. Have Casanova. Wait, have coming. Me. Oh. Sorry.
Bleep that.
Bleep that.
But we hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll see you guys next time. Mwah.
Hey, if you guys are still watching right now, comment down below.
Viva! Viva!